Would you remain standing for our invocation? On this beautiful morning on Bryan Hill, Father, we're so very grateful for your many blessings and mercies. We say with the psalmist, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless your holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and may we never forget all your benefits." Father, we thank you for each member of this graduating class, for how you have blessed and sustained these men and women through their time here at Bryan College. With all the graduates, we also thank you for each of the families and friends who are here to celebrate the accomplishment of graduation, and for the many sacrifices of time, energy, and finances that have gone into supporting each one of these students. Father, we thank you for the salvation we have in Christ our Savior, who is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation. Through him, all things were created, and in him, all things hold together. He is the firstborn from the dead so that he might reconcile all things to you, making peace by the blood of the cross. Father, we know we needed to be reconciled to you, and through the death, burial, and resurrection of your Son, you provided life, life eternal for each of us. May we live daily in that grace and the mercy that you have so lavishly given to us. May this college, which stands boldly for your name, for the salvation in Christ, for the work of your kingdom, may we always be a college that proclaims Christ above all. As we open this graduation exercise, Father, we ask that you bless our time together, and that you in your name above all things will be praised and glorified. It is in Christ's name that we pray. Amen. Please be seated. On behalf of the faculty and the staff and administration and the board of directors of Bryan College, I would like to welcome all of you, our distinguished guests, our family, friends, and especially the class of 2022, to the 122nd commencement exercises here at Bryan College. For more than 90 years, Bryan College has boldly stood for Christ above all. This motto reflects the founders' desire to see a college which, in the words of William Jennings Bryan, where students would receive an education where Christ was presented first. Now, for more than 9 decades, Bryan College has proudly sought to provide each student with the knowledge, values, and skills they will need to serve Christ and to serve their fellow man. Our desire is to see Christ work in and through each student, so that each will be a transformed difference maker in their homes, in their vocation and professional life, in their community, in their church. This is reflected in the mission of Bryan College, which is to educate students to become servants of Christ, to make a difference in today's world. Graduates, today you're receiving a diploma signifying the completion of a course of study and signaling the end of your time here at Bryan College. This parchment represents great sacrifices of time, energy, and expense. And I want to encourage you, though, to not let this be the end of the story. We've challenged you each to pursue academic excellence for the honor and glory of God, to seek to grow closer to Christ in discipleship, and to cultivate a heart of service to God and to others. While you now have the parchment noting the completion of your courses of study, your work is only beginning as you now apply what you have learned wherever God takes you and in whatever he calls you to do. Know that we are cheering for you, that we remain on call for you. You have my phone number. You really do. I gave it to you in your freshman year. And some of you are still using it. Know that we are praying for you, seeking the very best for you as you step away from Bryan Hill. Today we celebrate you and God's continued work in and through you. Graduates, today you're joined by many who have supported you along the way. I think it's appropriate to take a moment to honor them here at the outset of these commencement exercises. First, with the parents, the grandparents, the brothers, sisters, family of our graduates, would you stand to be recognized for the support and encouragement that you have provided to these students? Graduates, as you well know, Bryan holds dearly the value of community and of supporting one another. There's another group here on the Hill this morning who have been crucial in helping you reach this day. The Bryan College community has been privileged to be a part of the transformative work of God in your lives. With the team here at Bryan College, the coaches, the faculty, the staff, all of you, those of you who came alongside our students to encourage and to challenge, to guide and to mentor, would you please stand? Graduates and guests, would you please take a moment to recognize and thank them? Finally, we have three other very special people that I would like to introduce. First, so thankful that my wife Susie is here. She's my partner and friend in this journey. Students, you know her investment in your life and all the many things that she has done. Susie, would you please stand and be recognized? Second, we're very honored today to have Bryan College's fifth president, Dr. Ken Hanna, and his wife, Mary. I would invite you to stand while I say a few comments. Yesterday, we dedicated the President's House as the Hanna House in honor of their lifelong service to Christ, and to Christ's work here on Bryan's campus, and to Christ's work throughout their life. Dr. and Mrs. Hanna, we so thank you for your investment in Bryan College. We thank you for your service to Bryan College and for modeling a life of Christ above all. Thank you. Graduates, your years at Bryan have been quite memorable, to say the least. Many of you entered and had a normal year here on campus, which was followed by 2 years of the disruption of a global pandemic. Now, in this last year, we had again perhaps a more normal year, but we now face the challenges of a faltering economy and war. I've had a front seat with this class as my own daughter is among you. Susie and I have deeply enjoyed getting to engage with you in our home, on the fields and floors of competition, at the performing arts concerts, and wherever we had the privilege of spending time with you. God has granted each of you great gifts and skills. Thank you for sharing those with us while you've been here on this campus. The spirit of this class, I think, is partially captured in a story from your freshman year. You have all heard me speak of the legacy of prayer here at Bryan College. When alumni, friends, pastors, or students express that they are praying for Bryan or for our students, they sincerely mean it. Word reached me during your freshman year of a freshman student who was praying for her father and for a new job. I had no idea the situation nor even who the student was, but we shared in her prayer that her father would indeed find whatever position God had for him. God answered that prayer. They're all unique answers to prayer, but particularly unique in an unforeseen way when the father came and actually worked here at Bryan College. Little did I know that this young lady's prayer and this new coach were connected. Later, his brother would also join us, and then the entire extended family, moved to Dayton, and they are here with us today. It was only later that I made the connection between the daughter and her father, and was able to see the hand of God at work and his blessing on a family, our college, and our community. class, do not ever forget that legacy of prayer. The past few years have presented unforeseen challenges to families and communities. Another aspect of the spirit of this class, both here on our campus and especially with our online graduates, is the perseverance you have shown through all the trials you have encountered. Graduates, many of you have endured lengthy illnesses, or you've borne the pain of passing of relatives or close friends due to COVID or other illnesses. In this ever-changing world, the ability to persevere and focus long enough to see your dream come to fruition perhaps isn't the norm. There have been many changes and hardships over these last few years, and inevitably there are many students who are crossing this stage today who epitomize the phrase, slow and steady wins the race. One student enrolled in the online program in the fall of 2019 at the same time as her son. He had talked her into finishing her degree. Since that time, she has endured more than her share of trials. Her son was hospitalized with serious illness. Her husband was diagnosed with a life-altering disease. And her niece, who's like a daughter to her, lost her husband to COVID. Throughout these trials, she remained in her online program, and she'll walk the stage today having earned Latin honors with her degree. This story defines endurance in the face of hardship, to which our online community can certainly relate. It is with excitement that we congratulate our online and all our students for completing their degrees and reaching the finish line. From our team here on campus, we applaud your perseverance, your grit, your resolution. We congratulate you on achieving the completion of your degree. This year's campus verse comes from Paul's letter to the Romans. Paul writes, "Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind." I trust that Bryan College has been a place of transformation for each of you, a place where God has drawn you closer to himself. Our physical and digital classrooms are places where hearts and minds are transformed as we explore the world around us and better understand God's work in this world. The fields of competition and the stage of performances are places where we learn how to use these gifts and skills to display God's honor and glory. Students, my prayer, graduates, not students, my prayer is that this time of transformation and renewal of your mind and body does not end after your time here at Bryan. May God continually work in your heart and mind to be transformed by his grace and mercy, and always transforming to God's purpose in your life.
As Dr. Mann said, the mission of Bryan College is educating students to become servants of Christ to make a difference in today's world. Today, the lion's share of that work of education is complete. We hope that you have known service and that you will be servants in the days to come. How you will make a difference is in a large part going to be made in the workplace. And that can be done by understanding and living out a Christian worldview of work. And so today I'm going to read a passage from Ecclesiastes, chapter 5, verses 18 through 20, where we read, "Behold, what I have seen to be good and fitting is to eat and drink and find enjoyment in all the toil with which one toils under the sun, the few days of his life that God has given him, for this is his lot. Everyone also to whom God has given wealth and possessions and power to enjoy them and to accept his lot and rejoice in his toil, this is the gift of God. For he will not much remember the days of his life, because God keeps him occupied with joy in his heart." Did you catch that? Enjoyment of work is a gift of God. So my prayer for you today is not that you would find a good job, but that you would find good in the job you get.
Good morning. It's my pleasure to welcome you to the 102nd graduation ceremony at Bryan College. What an exciting day. After many sacrifices, much hard work, and many prayers, at the conclusion of today's ceremony, these graduates will begin a new chapter in their lives. Family and friends, thank you for joining us at this celebration, and also for the encouragement and support that you've given these students. We know that you are so proud of them, and so are we. Graduates, what a blessing it is that you are able to pursue your education at an institution where the motto is Christ above all. And what a blessing you have been to the faculty and the staff. No doubt there have been exciting and disappointing and interesting things along this journey. Thank you for allowing Bryan College to be a part of your life and to be your family. One of the highlights of my position as the chairman of the Board of Trustees is signing and presenting of diplomas. Today, as I present each diploma, I will be praying for each of you that you will find exactly the place God has for you and that He will bless you in that place. Today, at the end of the ceremony, we will have 242 more Bryan Lions out seeking to make a difference in today's world. God bless you.
Today, Bryan College is honored to have members of the graduating class of 1972. They're sitting here to my right, your left. During our commencement exercises, we celebrate our golden anniversary graduates by presenting each former student with a golden anniversary diploma. For our graduating students, for all our faculty and staff, this serves as a reminder of those who came before and the transformative experience they too had here on Bryan Hill. So let's briefly explore a bit about their time here at Bryan College. Dr. Ted Mercer was your president. You endured the much talked about and matchmaking event known as the President's Reception. We don't do that anymore. You also enjoyed the first 2 years of the All College Picnic, a tradition that endures to this day. You had a brand new drama club that presented the miracle worker to rave reviews. Among the many faculty and staff, and there were many, Mrs. Peck, Ms. Karen D. Rose, who is now Mrs. Traylor, Mr. Alan Winkler, Doc Anderson, and a newly minted Dr. Richard Cornelius. Wayne Dixon was on the athletic staff, and Dr. Jake Mathis was a coach and a math professor. His wife is one of our golden grads today. Among the many chapel speakers, you enjoyed Dr. John Oliver, great preacher and pastor from Augusta, and Dr. Kenneth Gangle. I'm sure that you will recall the many hours spent in the dorms, in the cafeteria, walking around the triangle where we now sit, developing friendships that would last a lifetime. We're honored that each of you are with us today. We're grateful for your ongoing support of this college, for your prayers for the students who continue to come to Bryan College. Perhaps most of all, we are grateful to God for His call on your life, your faithfulness in following Him, and the example you have set for all of us, holding Christ above all. Dr. Callen, would you come to the podium as I present these diplomas to our distinguished guests?
Mr. Barton Allen Boggs. Mrs. Mary Helen Hakes Boggs. Dr. Ardell Bruce Canaday, Mrs. Lois Neal Canaday, Mrs. Annette Winkler Edgeberg, Mrs. Martha Jones Ferris, Mrs. Lois Renger Fisher, Mr. Edward H. Fritz, Mrs. Judy Triplett Fritz, Dr. Marcia Stewart Fromke, Mrs. Jane Scott Graham, Mr. Larry A. Jacobson, Dr. Timothy James Kimmel, Mr. Philip Ray Leffler, Mr. H. Philip Long, Ms. Sandra Gibson Long, Mr. Mark Longnecker, Dr. John Dallas Main, Mrs. Clarice McCarthy Main, Dr. Sandra Schmickel Mathis, Ms. Carol Wilson Moore, Mr. David Vernon Otto, Mr. Paul Harry Peterson, Ms. Lynn Leopold Peterson, Mr. Donald P. Pierce, Ms. Carol Walters Pierce, Mr. George Joseph Poole III, Mr. Paul Charles Ryder, Mr. Stephen L. Sanford, Mrs. Susan Reynolds Sanford, Mrs. Eleanor Quigley Straley, Mr. Charles Eugene Summers, Mrs. Yvonne Jenkins Talent, Mrs. Linda Weld Vaughn,
It is my honor to present the following awards. Please stand when your name is called and see me after the ceremony to receive your award. Annual awards are given to two students in the senior class in accordance with the terms specified by the original underwriter of the award, Mr. P.A. Boyd of Bloomfield, New Jersey. These awards are given to the students whose powers and attainments of body and mind and whose principles and character have secured for them the highest degree of influence over their fellow students. Candidates for these prizes must manifest nobility of character, fearlessness, and self-sacrificing devotion to the ideals of a purposeful life, and an active identification in constructive work for the best interest of student life in the college. The awards this year go to Zachary Carlos Portilla and Jessica Vest. The selection for the Judson A. Rudd Testimony and Influence Award is made by the freshman class in a secret ballot. This award is given to a senior having an outstanding Christian testimony and exerting the best Christian influence on incoming students. Dr. Rudd was the third president of Bryan from 1933 to 1955. The award goes to Joshua Goodpastor. The highest Scholastic Record Award is given to the senior who has completed at least 112 semester hours at Bryan and has the highest grade point average while attending Bryan. There are four recipients this year who all earned a 4.0 GPA. Joseph Curry, Jessica Gaddy, Laurel McLaughlin, and Skylar Wetzig. The Alumni Director, Ms. Paula K. Hall, will now present the Alumni Award for Faithfulness and Loyalty.
Good morning. The awards this year go to two legacy students, Anna Leah Benoit and Russell Green.
Transparency, I gave a speech in high school at my graduation, and I tripped and fell off the stage and landed on my face and rolled my ankle, so I'm a little bit nervous being up here today. Thank you, Dr. Mann, for those wise words you gave us earlier. I really appreciate those. To my fellow graduates, thank you for allowing me the privilege to speak on this stage and represent you. That being said, I am a STEM major, so I guess this is the true test of my liberal arts education at Bryan. To all the family and friends who have helped us get to this point in our lives, thank you. To my parents specifically, thank you for your constant love and support. The world would be a much better place if everyone could have as good of parents as I've had. To the faculty and staff who have been a part of our lives for the past 4 years, thank you. A big part about what makes Bryan College special is the faculty and staff, whether that's a supportive resident director, an ARC student success coach who serves her students so well, a cleaning lady who calls you beautiful or gorgeous on your way to class, a president who gives his phone number out during chapel, or a professor who generally wants the best for you even if you do make bald jokes at his expense during class. Sorry, Dr. Smith. Bryan has been a place that has shaped us. We have made memories to last a lifetime here, like winning a conference championship, spending time with family and friends in common grounds, proposing to your girlfriend after winning homecoming king and queen, fitting 15 people around a cafeteria table, late night Walmart runs, being called puddin' by an old lady at a banquet. When Dr. Mann walks in on the volleyball team bonding and Smalls is putting pantyhose over her clothes, I don't know why. An inflatable dinosaur costume for dress-up day, body-to-body in red, lip-sync battles with friends, Russell Green running through a wall on the third floor of Mercer. I have a video if you want to see it, and I'm pretty sure you can see the new sheetrock up, too. The giant slip and slide behind Rudd, exploring pretty waterfalls, the Houston Hive team meetings, almost setting off fire alarms with birthday cake candles, Dr. Hill literally pulling quizzes out of his socks, and making a concrete canoe that floats, and many, many more amazing memories. Now we close this chapter of our lives with some of those great times to make us laugh and smile later on. As we prepare for the next chapter in our lives, I ask that you consider two things. First, am I positively impacting the people around me? And second, am I letting the thought of being uncomfortable stop me from achieving a goal? Oftentimes I hear speeches about changing the world. They inspire and motivate people to act against a cause. Let me be clear today, I am not and will never ask you to change the world. That, quite frankly, sounds like a lofty and unrealistic goal to set upon you. I personally don't want that on my shoulders. But what I am asking you to do, graduates and even graduates' family and friends, is to positively impact the people's lives that you are surrounded by. That can be family, friends, coworkers, or random people that you see at the grocery store. Earlier, I read some of my fellow graduates' favorite memories from Bryan's that they so graciously emailed me, because I was very late in sending out that email. What those memories have in common is that they all involve more than one person. The world changes through the individual connections. And those individual people that we affect go on to affect other people, and those people affect other people, and those people affect other people. And I know what you're thinking, that might sound like a pyramid scheme. But hey, it worked for Jesus with his 12 apostles. And if it makes you feel better, I guess you can call it the butterfly effect. My second ask was that you do not let being uncomfortable stop you from achieving a goal or a calling. I think that's a pretty straightforward concept, but it's by no means easy. Hey, maybe this is your sign to ask that someone special that you've been crushing on for 4 years. I just request that if it does work out, that you name your firstborn after me. And that's Taylor with an ER. In all seriousness, Jesus does not call us to a life of ease. He asked his disciples to drop everything and follow him, to pick up their crosses daily. To quote Josh Watkins, we grow in Christ the most when we leave what is comfortable to us in pursuit of him and his plan. The growth is found in the stretching. So remember, graduates, to positively impact the people around you and get uncomfortable. And in case somehow you miss it at your time at Bryan College, God loves you unrelentingly, and he sent his son Jesus to die for our sins that we may have everlasting life with him. Thank you.
Holy Jesus, praise his name. clap those hands.
Praise come his on, holy clap name. Those hands. Praise
come
his
on,
name.
Come on, come on.
Oh, oh, praise his holy name. Praise
he
his name.
Is the word that.
Praise his holy name. Praise
come
his
on,
name.
Come on, come on, come
oh,
on.
Oh, praise his holy name. Name.
Thank you, students. That was beautiful. Today, Bryan College is deeply privileged to have the Honorable Ken Yeager as our distinguished guest and commencement speaker. Senator Yeager has served our community and the state of Tennessee since 2008 as the senator for the 12th District. This is a 7-county district, which for now includes Rhea County and Dayton. Prior to his election to the state senate, Senator Yeager served as Roane County Executive for 24 years. Senator Yeager has committed much of his professional life to public service, and he's no stranger to education, having served as a history teacher, a litigator, a professor of law at several K-12 as well as higher education institutions. He's a graduate from the University of Tennessee at Martin with a degree in history. I'm a history major. In 1969, and he received his master's from UT Martin in 1972. He earned his Juris Doctorate from the University of Memphis in 1977. Senator Yeager and his wife Melinda reside in Kingston, and they recently celebrated 37 years of marriage. They have two children, Bonnie Marie and Will. We are honored today to have Senator Yeager join us. He has been a great friend to Bryan College, as well as to me personally. Would you join me in welcoming Senator Ken Yeager to Bryan College?
Thank you, Dr. Mann, for your very kind words of introduction, and thank you very much for the privilege to speak to these honored graduates today. Delivering this commencement address is a very special opportunity that I'm very grateful to have, and as I said already, and I'll say it once more, I'm so very honored to be here, standing here, gracing this platform and speaking to you. It's a privilege to me because Bryan College is special to me. I was introduced to Bryan College back in the 1980s when a courthouse employee, the late Marietta Roberts, if anyone should remember, introduced me to Bryan because her children were students here and brought me down here to a Christmas concert. I believe it was in the basement of Rudd. That was my introduction. And started a relationship with Bryan College that has grown and flourished over the years. In addition, my daughter, Bonnie Marie, was a graduate of Bryan College in 2007. And of course, when I came to the Senate, I have served Rhea County, which included Bryan College. It was giving me every opportunity that I can to support the college. Because you see, since 1930, almost a century now, Bryan College has prepared thousands of men and women for the workforce and community leadership. Ministers, missionaries, lawyers, doctors, nurses, soldiers,
philosophers, business leaders, just to name a few. We see the programs expand from just the bachelor program now to the master's program. We've added engineering and nursing and other specialized programs. Bryan College is a leader in education, it is a leader in this community. And you honored graduates, you are now joining this distinct group of alumni. So I say congratulations to you. Heartfelt congratulations to you on a job well done. Those who love you and support you are here, and they join me in that. Congratulations to you. But you know, in the time of any celebration, we're invariably going to focus a little bit on the future. And I don't know about you, but when I went through those graduation exercises, I got asked more than once these questions. Maybe you have too. Well, what are you going to do? Where will I land? If you were to ask those questions, you've probably searched your own soul to ask yourself those questions. And I can answer those questions today for you, because I can say without reservation or hesitation that you will land on your feet marching successfully into the future because you have been well equipped academically and professionally, spiritually, by outstanding faculty that is committed to academic rigor taught from a Christian worldview. No doubt in my mind, you'll land on your feet and you're going the only direction I know, forward. And it's my prayer today that God will prosper your efforts here at Bryan College. And I know that he will, because I know that it's your prayer and desire to be in his will. How I wish, if you don't mind, a personal moment or two, how I wish my late mother were here. She'd be so proud of you. You see, she took a great interest in young people like you, always encouraging them to get the best education available. She, my mother, appreciated the value of a good education because she never had one. She was a child of the Great Depression in the 1930s and had to quit school when she was in the sixth grade to go to work in a bakery to support her brothers and her sisters. Because she never had the chance to complete that education is truly the reason why she understood its life-changing value. So if you don't mind, I'd like to take a few moments and share with you just a few things, a few principles that I've learned from my mother's example. Not only was my mother robbed of her education by the Depression, she married young, started a family, but my dad died when I was 4 years old and left my mother to take care of me and my three older sisters. So you can see a young, single mom, not really educated or equipped, had four kids to raise. But during this tough time, she kept us together, and by that example taught me several life experiences that I hope in just the remaining moment or two that I have to share with you. First, the importance of being an encourager. Anybody.
Find the good in someone and let them know that. And I must say, on occasion, you may think, well, it's hard to find good in that person. But find the good in someone. Remember, we're all created in God's image. Find the good in someone and let them know it. Because encouragement provides hope and motivation. And believe me, in this world today, if we ever needed hope, we need it now. And you can help with that by being an encourager. My mother was an encourager. She encouraged me to get the best possible education, and she made sacrifices, which you might be called upon to do, to be an encourager. She took in children to help me pay for my law school. So be an encourager. Find the good in someone. Be prepared to commit that time or make that sacrifice to give somebody hope or motivation. And I promise you, not only will they benefit, but you will too. Two, the value of a strong work ethic. When Dad died, my mother had to work night and day to keep us living. She did this by operating a small grocery store out of the basement of our four-room house. Modest by any means, the store's floors were swept clean by her every day. The countertops were spot-free, and the glass cases glistened because she took pride in her work. It was tough work, but she took pride in her work. My mother's inexhaustible energy taught me that there is value in honorable work. So whatever you do, do it honestly and do it to the best of your ability. Trusting God, He'll help you. The same God that's walked with me every step of my life is there for you too. And He's with you right now, and He won't leave you. Which brings me to the third principle my mother left me. An absolute necessity in the faith in God. Never once did my mother allow the demands of being a single mom serve as an excuse to miss Sunday school or church. And some of my earliest childhood memories are from when I was in Sunday school. And from those early days, many, many years ago, Sunday school and the fellowship with believers and the spiritual growth that's available through church and Sunday school have been a mainstay in my life. I'm grateful to my mother for setting me in the right direction. And I know that you understand how important the faith is, since we are graduating from a school that puts Christ above all. So let me say, in encouragement, be an encourager, work hard and honorably, keep the faith. My mom would be proud of you. In fact, we're all so very proud of you here today. I salute you. I join the president, the faculty, your family, friends, all of us today. One of the largest crowds we have ever had at a Bryan commencement. We salute you for your accomplishment. And I promise, I expect to hear nothing but great things about each of the graduates in the days ahead. Congratulations. Remember to always put Christ above all. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Yeager.
Will the graduates who received the Master's of Arts, Master of Business Administration, and Master of Education please rise? Mr. President, on behalf of the faculty of Bryan College, it is my privilege to present to you the students who have completed all the requirements for the degree of Master of Arts, Master of Business Administration, and Master of Education.
On behalf of the Board of Trustees and by right of incorporation by the State of Tennessee, it is my privilege to confer on you the Master of Business Administration and Master of Education degrees with all the rights, honors, and privileges attendant to this degree. You may move your tassel.
Will the graduates of Master of Arts, Master of Business Administration, and Master of Education please make your way to the stage? Lindsay Aaron Fay. Rena Ann Carroll. Jerry Lynn Cameron. Cynthia Ann Singleton. Olivia Joy Hancock. Megan Ariel Martinez. Shelby Louise Nicole Newell. Jennifer King. Catherine Elizabeth Hart Patmore. Phaedra Matthews Walker. Kimberly Mitchell Lattimore. Wesley Caroline Clark. Isabella Brianne Dawson. Abigail Hope Webb. Alexandria Mackenzie West. McKenna Dawn Giles. Carly Autumn Combs. Kerrigan Danielle Triola. Laura Ann Dodson. Kaylee Lynn Hedrick. Chu Hao Lin. Alyssa Leanne Valentine. Caitlin Elizabeth Kane. Caitlin Elizabeth Jones. Samuel Whitaker Jones. Megan Angel Varner. Brooke Lachey Morris. Caitlin Michelle Mormon. Nicholas Reese Roach. Colin Joseph Kearney. Michael Joseph Cody. Casey Renee Kalk. Matthew Christian Warren. Blake Daniel Bates. Javier Espinoza Jr. Jason A. Hobbs. Angelia C. Price. Michelle Ann Sutherland. Kathy Leanne Smith. Andrew Paul Apple. Walker James Frizzell. Katrina Elaine Chesney. Jonathan LeGrant Cooper. Tiffany Elaine Norman. Chadwick Keith Morrison. Nicholas Tyler Bennett. Thank you. Chesney Johnston Ferris. Megan B. Carter. Asia Deanna Grimes. Thank you. Lindsay Shadwick. Kristen Samantha Gilley. Elizabeth Nicole Dahl. Kristen Riggs. Jacob Daniel Griswold. Will the graduates who receive the Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Business Administration, Bachelor of Science, and Bachelor of Science and Engineering degrees please rise? It It had to be me. I've got my stuff packed in a box. Mr. President, on behalf of the faculty of Bryan College, it is my privilege to present to you the students who have completed all the requirements for the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Business Administration, Bachelor of Science, and Bachelor of Science in Engineering.
By the State of Tennessee, it is my privilege to confer on you the Bachelor of Arts, the Bachelor of Business Administration, the Bachelor of Science, and the Bachelor of Science in Engineering. These degrees with all the rights, honors, and privileges attendant, you may move your tassel.
Will the graduates of the Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Business Administration, Bachelor of Science, and Bachelor of Science Engineering please make your way to the stage?
Kyle David Argo. Grant David Heiser. Dylan Hall Melvin. Luke Alexander Peterson. Zachary Carlos Portillo, magna cum laude. Jessica Hope Vest, summa cum laude. Devin Bryn Noel Davidson, cum laude. Skylar Wetzig, summa cum laude. Jamin Tavis Pearson, cum laude. C. Mateus Schwartzen, summa cum laude. Macy Lynn Shaver. Braylee Ora Franklin. Parker Cosby. Jaron Elijah Henry. Justin Wayne Ogle. Michael Edward Harrell. Desmond Isaiah Sales. Laurel Yvonne McLaughlin, summa cum laude. Emily Caitlin Price. Andrew Johnson, summa cum laude. John Jason Graff, summa cum laude. Micah Scott Cannon. Lisa K. Jaycox, summa cum laude. Latasha Nicole Rice. Shaylin Marie Jackson. Megan Nicole Whited. Maya Hill Mosley. Amy L. Waters, cum laude. Bonnie Swanner Blankenship, magna cum laude. Mandy Grace Prescott, summa cum laude. Rachel L. Bilbrey, magna cum laude. Zipporah A. Melvin. Alyssa Jo Morgan Chansey. Kaylin Diane Williams. Megan B. Crow, summa cum laude. Justin Allen Hurst. Holly Janice Stanfield. Stephanie Paige Shelton, magna cum laude. Tinshay Woodruff. Jeffrey Lee French. Jeremy Len Harris, summa cum laude. James Casey Pendleton, summa cum laude. Todd Heath Culberson, summa cum laude. Jamie Nicole Bettis. Christina Hagler, cum laude. Jenna Lay Ryan, summa cum laude. Angela Diane Roberts, magna cum laude.
Anessa Quinn Cook Rose. Ashlyn Deshay Marler. Jalen Rylea Schmidt. Haley Danielle Pryor. Whitney Ann Brown. Camille Alita Holly. Jessica Ruth Gaddy. Haley Nicole Smith, magna cum laude. Sarah Grace Welch, summa cum laude. Jonathan David Nelson. Joseph Samuel Curie, summa cum laude. Joshua Alexander Bianchi. Randy Marie Hazelwood, summa cum laude. Seton Lee Dasher, cum laude. Elena Kirsten Hill, cum laude. Carla Gabriella Oliveira. Abigail Olivia Sawyer. Matthew Stephen Keck. Joshua Michael Cotton, summa cum laude.
Elisha Hardiman.
Yeah.
Thomas Franklin Land, summa cum laude. Rebecca Jane Camacho. Shira Lasana Four. Jocelyn Mendoza. Tori Burnett. Charlie Madison Mitchell. Britton Marie White. Riley Renee Evans, magna cum laude. Elijah Jeffrey Kirk. Andrew Fisher, magna cum laude. Seth Hill, cum laude. Analia Grace Benoit. Haley Cheyenne Galvin.
Brianna Nagelhout,
cum laude. Brianna Lynn Hickey, magna cum laude. Destiny Pauline McSwain. Shannon Dell White, cum laude. Mariah Dawn Sober. Flannery Faith Ann Carpenter, summa cum laude. Peter William Brown, magna cum laude. Parker Harrison Hill. Brady Lewis Hill. Jared Lee Price, summa cum laude. Jacob Connor Hallmark. Trevor Ryan Ferguson. Nathan Cornell. Vincent Baumgartner. Gregory E. Brown, summa cum laude. Shayla Ludi. Charles Spencer. Tyree Bailey. Brandon Michael Thomas. Noah Christian Mulaski, summa cum laude. Matthew Edward Graham. Bethany W. Pendleton, cum laude. Aaliyah Worley, cum laude. Destiny Brooke Kastner. Sarah K. Kinslow. Paige Ann Randolph, summa cum laude. Hannah Elizabeth D'Arman. Lucas Evan Travis. Tanner Alexander Harvey, magna cum laude. Dalton Cole Conley. Joanna Dylan Deanne Conley, cum laude. Adam M. Sanders. Rachel Ann Birdieshaw. McKenna Grace Manier, summa cum laude. Abigail Grace Little, summa cum laude.
Last name Yeager.
Sophia Yeager, summa cum laude. Catherine McClellan. Elizabeth Diane Spencer, cum laude. Joshua Lee Goodpastor. Colin Hunter Lee Wright. Michaela Claire Marshall, summa cum laude. Mary Alice Laxton, cum laude. Sarah Alexis Portillo. Faith Lauren Lovelady. Margaret Hannah Mann, summa cum laude. Anna Grace Autry, summa cum laude. Audrey Anna Smith, cum laude. James Barber. Jason Lanham Jr. Colin Daniel O'Rear, cum laude. Andrew Edward Johnson. Caitlin Grace Ray. Alyssa Ann Reese. Caitlin Ann Novak, magna cum laude. Katrina Ruth Ingalls, summa cum laude. Hannah Autumn Burt, summa cum laude. Philip Kane Buttram, magna cum laude. Monica Dawn Armstrong. Holly Elise Congdon. Jeffrey Clinton Buckner. Sarah Elizabeth Crumbly, summa cum laude. Shamika Hudgens.
Julia Ann Martin, summa cum laude. Taylor Montana Forsman. Peyton Thomas Lawyer, summa cum laude. Jonah Cruz Tyree. Lyle Clifford Smith IV, magna cum laude. Russell N. Green, cum laude. Justin Warner. Tristan William Allison.
Would you please stand for the singing of the alma mater? You can find the text on the back of the program. Please remain standing and come with me as let us go to the Father in prayer. Heavenly Father, we come before you just as we are, tired, hopeful, frightened, encouraged, both relieved and anxious. We come to you, Father. We come to you, recognizing you as King, the master planner of life. We pray for wisdom. Bless these students, Father, as they go into the world. Bring to their mind the lessons they've learned, the people and with and from whom they have studied. We pray for faithfulness as we all leave and encounter the joys and the trials of life. May we remember to be faithful to the scriptures, faithful in our friendships, faithful in our marriages, and faith-filled followers of Christ. Father, may your blessing be on these students. May it be on these families and these friends, this faculty, staff, these coaches, these administrators, Senator Yeager, and on Bryan College. Father, it's in the name of your Son that we pray. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you.